Today is Joey's birthday, and his request for dinner was paella. So I'm making a delicious seafood paella. And I made it before, and it turned out wonderful. So I'm hoping this time I have the same luck. I even made the saccharat perfectly. And saccharat, if you're just joining me and I didn't say it before, is called bun bun. That's what Jamaican people call bun bun. It's where the bottom of the pan has a burnt part on the rice, and it tastes absolutely delicious. Yes. So thank you again for joining me for another episode of Carla's Kitchen Chronicle. This delicious glass of wine and a great recipe. Cheers, and I'll see you in the kitchen. All right, guys, I'm just gonna highlight some of my recipes. You know how I like to do that. That's the clam rings. We got the onions back there. We have the bell pepper, tomato, wine. That's the saffron in the water. And we also have the lemon juice. And my garlic is in that. That's actually I am putting some crawfish in there, and that's the crawfish we had a little left over. I'm just gonna put it in there at the last minute. The shrimp and the mussels are in the cooler, already cleaned up and ready to go. And of course you have to have these special rice. All right, so I'll see you guys again shortly.
I got my olive oil heating in my pan here. And once it's hot, we'll start the process. Seems like it maybe.
All right, the oil is hot, so we're gonna go ahead and add our sea salt. Probably can't hear the music, but I'm jamming over here. And then I'm gonna go ahead and add my squid. I did pressure cook my squid a little bit, and they're soft, so I hope I didn't mess them up too much. But I don't like when I bite into a squid and it's not doesn't have a nice little firmness to it. I mean, it's a little softness to it.
Squid was fried up for 2 minutes, and I've been taking it out, so I'm taking it out and putting it to the side.
I turned it down, of course, a little bit, and now I'm going to go ahead and add the onions and the garlic to the pan. And the reason why I turned it down is because I never want to burn my garlic. The onions. Lost a few garlics on the ground there. I'm gonna let this saute for about a minute. And then it'll be time to add my bell peppers. Like I said, I turned down low because I don't want my stuff to be burnt. This is not a non-stick pot, as y'all can see. I love this pot, but it's not a non-stick pot. It is just regular stainless steel pot. Time to add my tomatoes. And it says, some recipe says tomato puree or tomato, diced tomato from a can, but you know what? I am using fresh tomatoes. And that's like I diced up three garden tomatoes. So yeah, we're gonna let that cook for it. We're gonna add our smoked paprika, if I can speak today. All right. That's my generous amount of smoked paprika. My sea salt. And my cracked black pepper. If I can get it to work. All right. Then we're also going to stir this in together. And
let's simmer for a
minute. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and add the squid back to the pot. My grandbaby got the, he got a hold of the camera there. It's all right, it's all right. We saved it. Smile, you're on candy camera. The family's here for Joe's birthday. So I'm making a dish that everyone can eat. Romello has his own separate dish. So we put the squid back in the pot. And I'm using, I couldn't find seafood broth and I didn't want to travel to every store. So I'm using vegetable broth. Half a cup of that right there for now. Stir that in. And we're gonna let that cook for a little bit. I'm also gonna go ahead and add my saffron, which I had in water. You could just put the, you could use saffron powder, but I couldn't find that. And like I said, I was lazy and wasn't gonna hunt everything down. So that's what I did the last time and I'm doing that again. Guys, I'm gonna go ahead and add my wine, my white wine. Look at that, right here. And I'm also gonna add a half a cup more of vegetable broth. And I'm gonna let that come to a boil before I put the rice to it, okay? All right, and also I'm gonna add my lemon juice. Stir that in, and add a little more salt and pepper, sea salt. I'm using sea salt, which doesn't, it's not really that salty. And a little more black pepper. And this is just me doing this, it doesn't call for that. It's up to you if you wanna add a little more, cause I'm tasting my flavor as I go, okay? And I'm also going to add a little more paprika. Okay, the water is boiling, so I'm gonna go ahead and add my rice. All right, that's one cup. And that's two cups. And I'm gonna get this in there. I'm cooking more than the recipe called for because I have more than the recipe called for. So I'm gonna go ahead and distribute this rice in the pot. Get it in there, don't stir it. Just distribute it with your spoon. Get it, you know. Get it in there. Real nice. Just do it as much as you can. Distribute it, and then you're just gonna let it cook on low for a little bit. Okay, guys, it's time to go ahead and put in the shrimps and the mussels. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and lay them in here. I like listening to music from whatever region or country of the dish I'm making. That way I know I better come correct when I'm making the dish. So let me go ahead and lay these, and then I'm gonna lay a lot of shrimps, as well as I have a good amount of mussels, because you know, it's the family, so we're gonna enjoy this. I'm gonna go ahead and lay my mussels and already wash them and you know, clean them up. So I'm gonna go ahead and put them in and just lay them in here as much as I can. All right, I'm gonna keep doing that until it's folded. My mussels are in, that's what it looks like. I'm gonna shake my pot a little bit and then, wait a minute, it's not done yet. I'm gonna go ahead and add my little bit of crawdads I had in here on top. But wait, there's a little bit of juice in there, so I'm gonna go ahead and do this, my little rice hat covering, so I can steam this rice in the pot properly, and it is gonna be turned down to low, all right? Okay, it's been 10 minutes, so let's see what we got. Oh, well, I'm gonna let this cook open for a little bit, but you know,
It doesn't look as great as the first time I made it, but you know what? I'm happy. And we're gonna let this the water dry out some, because I guess some of this stuff had water. And then we'll finish it up. Right, so I turned it up and I'm making the sakara, the bonbon. I didn't turn it up too high because this stove is a little different. You gotta know your stove. So I have it up where it's gonna get the crust going, but it's not gonna burn. So that's what's going on right now. And just for a little bit. And you know your stove, you know your pot, just make sure it's not burning right. Folks, I think that's enough for that sakara. And I'm gonna go ahead and put my parsley, of course. Fresh parsley from our garden. And my lemon wedges. So the family can enjoy this with their own lemon wedges. And that's pretty much it's done.